flats of 200 into 8 mm thickness and 200 into 6 mm thickness are connected by a lap joint as shown at the side. The ultimate stress in the weld is 410 Newton per mm square. Find the tensile stress. In the previous example, we have seen two flat plates which are connected by a lap joint where the thickness of the two plates are same, equal of uniform thickness. In this question, in this particular question, see the thickness of the first plate is 8 mm and the plate which is kept below is 6 mm. So, this example is completely different from our previous example. So, step 1, given data, that is flat plate 1, that is 200 into 8 mm. Flat plate 2, F2 is equal to 6 mm, that is 200 into 6 mm. In previous case, we have given the thickness of the plate, that is 8 mm. But in this question, the thickness is not given. So, we need to find thickness. So, we need to design the thickness and we should solve the problem. Clear? So, the weld is done in the side. So, partial safety factor is taken as 1.50. The ultimate shear stress in the weld, that is Fu, is equal to 410 Newton per mm square. The first step is completed. Let us see the second step. Step 2, size of the weld. Since we are having two different thickness of the plates, we may get two different size of the weld. So, size of the weld S1 is equal to the first size of the thickness of the plate is 8 mm. So, T minus 1.5 mm, that is 8 minus 1.5 mm, that is 6.5 mm. For calculation purpose, we can take 6 mm. That is the first size of the weld, the thickness of the plate is 8 mm, that is 6 mm. S2, second size of the weld, since you know the thickness of the plate is given as 6, 6 minus 1.5 mm, we get 4.5 mm, approximately we can take as 4 mm, approximately we can take as 4 mm. Step 3. Effective length. So, in this particular case, we will be getting two different effective lengths. So, because the thickness is different, as the size of the welds are also different, thickness of the plates are also different. So, effective length 1 is equal to L minus 2 into S. So, what is the length? 200 minus 2 into 6. So, 200 minus 12, what is 200 minus 12? That is 188 mm. This is the first effective length. Let us find second effective length. L minus 2 into S, that is 200 minus 2 into 4, and the size of the second weld is 4 mm. That is 200 minus 8, that is 192 mm. What is step 4? That is given in the question itself. That will be given in the question itself. That is ultimate shear stress in the weld. That is ultimate shear stress in the weld. So, I will be writing here itself. Step 4 and step 5. Directly I will be writing here itself. You know the ultimate shear stress in the weld Fu is equal to 410 Newton per mm square. The design stress in the weld, that is F sub x w d, is equal to Fu by root 3 into 1.50. So, the answer is 410 divided by root 3 into 1.50. So, please do not get confused, because here itself I have written step 4 along with step 5. So 410 divided by root 3 into 1.50 into 1.50, we may get 157.80 Newton per mm square. Now let us find step 6, that is design strength. Actually we are having two effective lengths, so we can directly write 0.7 into size of the weld into effective length 1 into F double D plus 0.7 into second size of the plate, that is S2 into effective length 2 into F double D. So in this particular case 0.7 F double D is common. So 0.7 into, what is the first size of the weld? 6 mm. So what is the first effective length? 188 mm into what is design strength, that is 157.8 plus 0.7. What is size of the second size of the weld? That is 4 mm. What is second effective length? 192 into 157.8. So PD is equal to 0.7 into 6 into 188 into 157.8 plus 0.7 into 4 into 192 into 157.8 divided by 3. So 210 kilonewtons. So please don't get confused or panic by seeing this big step, because in previous case we are having only one effective length, so I took only one effective length. But in this case we are having two effective lengths, because as the thickness of the plate is changing and also size of the plate, size of the weld is also different, we are having as two size of the weld. So in design strength we may get 0.7 into S1 into L1 into FWD plus 0.7 into S2 into L2 into FWD. So 0.7 FWD is common, right? We can take common and solve this question. The last step is step 7. So I'll be doing here. Step 7. Design tensile stress in flat. TD is equal to 2 times of design strength in the weld by area of the plate. Or area of the flat. In examination formulas are very important, so you must write them. So 2 into what is design strength in the weld, that is 210 into 10 power 3. So what is area of the plate, so which area we need to take? So you may get confusion which area. So let us take the area which is small, that is 200 into 6. Let us solve it. So 2 into 210 into 10 power 3 divided by 200 into 6, we may get 350 Newton per mm square is a design tensile stress of the two flats. So this is the answer.